As you heard the message one more time, what a tremendous, tremendous message, amen, from the Word of God. And, it come across my heart and mind tonight, no doubt our country is in that place. And that's been, we give evidence to that time and time and time again, that we would rather have our pleasures and our popularities than we had God. We're going to pay for it, and we are paying for it. But I want to tell you, friend, the danger zone that we live in today is our church. Our churches today have become what our country was 50 years ago. We have begun to say, Lord, we would rather have this than we had you. We would rather have our own way than we had your way. And he's standing on the outside the door. In Revelation 2, he's in the church working and doing great things. By Revelation 3, he's standing at the door knocking, said, I want back in. As they sing the song tonight, y'all come, the Lord spoke to your heart. Time and time again, as I've preached through the years, I've seen sinners under Holy Ghost conviction, the Word of God plowing their heart, pricking that life. And you'll see them come, and you'll see them put off salvation and being saved. And they can come again over and over and over. And then that one that used to sit up on the edge of the pew, gripping the pew in front of him, under Holy Ghost conviction, can now sit back with ease. The Holy Ghost is departing. Well, you ought to get in while you can. You ought to get in while the Holy Ghost passes by. You won't get in any other way. He said, no man can come to me except the Father which has sent me draw him. As we sing this song, you ought to come tonight.
Page 370.
As the Lord convicted your heart.
Faith without works is dead. We like Ephesians 2:8-9, for we are saved.
good works. When he saves you, amen, there'll be a brand new creature made in you. And you'll start doing a work, amen, for the Lord Jesus that will give evidence to the fact that you've been born again. This crowd that all they've got of God is the day that they come to church. There's nothing else going on in their life, no desire for him. If he should gain the whole world and lose his own soul, what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? I want to tell you, you've traded your soul in for some very cheap things in our day. Don't play around with Holy Ghost conviction. Our hearts and minds clear. And I tell you, if the Holy Ghost won't get you down, 19 versions of Just As I Am won't get you. The Holy Ghost of God, amen, is able to convict and convert sinners into the family of God. I tell you, the day that I got saved, amen, I didn't need a song. I didn't need anybody leading me in a sinner's prayer, amen. I didn't need no ABCs and 1, 2, 3s. All I needed to get to the altar and say, Lord, save me. And he saved me that day, amen, and I've been saved ever since, amen, over 20 years ago. And I thank God that it's real in my life, amen. I know that Christ liveth in me, amen. He's alive and well. And if you don't have that assurance tonight, friend, you ought to get that assurance. I can't give that to you. Mama can't give it to you. Daddy can't give it to you. But there's a Holy Ghost of God, amen, that can give you that assurance from the Word of God that you're a child of His. Romans chapter number 8, verse 16, the Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God, amen. Every now and then, amen, he stands up in there and says, hey, you belong to me, my child. Everything's going to be okay. Amen. Do you ever get that? Amen. Does he ever stand up on the portals of your soul and say, it's all right? My child, amen. Amen. I'm glad that he does. That's what he says, brother. Peace, amen. Peace, amen. Only God can give that peace tonight. Thank you, preacher, for another tremendous message, amen, from the Word of God. We've been blessed this week to hear the truth, amen, from God's Word. I'm telling you, we've heard it ever since Sunday morning, all the way through Friday night, message after message after message. God throwing out a lifeline, amen, to the church, amen. I want to tell you, friend, if you're saved tonight, you've got to know that this, and got any kind of discernment, you can tell this week that God, the Holy Ghost, has thrown out lifeline after lifeline after lifeline to the church of the living God, saying it's time to move on, it's time to quit going wayward and astray, amen. Put God back into the preeminence of your life, let him have your way, amen. We've heard it over and over and over again this week, amen. You know what? God's trying to get us a message, amen. I hope we received that message this week. Been on target, amen. Been just what I needed to hear, amen. I appreciate the Holy Ghost, amen, speaking to my heart over and over again this week from the Word of God. Our hearts and minds clear. We appreciate your patience and attendance this week, being faithful to come. Amen. We will take up an offering tonight before we leave, amen, to try to be a blessing to the man of God, amen. And they drove a long ways, amen, and spent a lot of time in the motel room this week, amen, to come and be a blessing to us, amen. We want to be a blessing to them, amen. They've certainly been a tremendous blessing. I'd like to say tonight, too, amen, I commend you, preacher, amen, for your children, amen. They've been well-behaved this week. And I want to tell you, that goes a long ways, amen, for me, amen. Them children have been well-behaved this week, and it speaks a lot, amen, of the raising they get back at home, amen, and I praise the Lord for that, amen. It's been a blessing, all right? We're going to go on and get Brother Brad to come, amen. We'll take up an offer.